Bismillah, bismillah, wa alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa lah, ma ba'd. Allah Ta'ala tells us in the Qur'an, we're going to be coming up to these ayat very shortly. Ba'd a'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. Shh, if we could just be a little bit more quiet, just struggle with him. Allah Ta'ala says, or do you think that you will enter paradise while such trials have not yet come to you as came to those who passed before you? They were touched by poverty and hardship and were shaken until even their messenger and those who believed with him said, when is the help of Allah? Unquestionably, the help of Allah is near. So this is a very interesting question, because in Arabic, if you're going to start and ask, do you think something, you would say, أحسبتم, أحسبتم. But Allah says, أم حسبتم, or. Or only comes after either, you know, either or. So subhanAllah, it seems as if there is mahdoof, an understood statement, an implied concept, as if Allah is saying, either do you understand that each of these stories in this Quran represents a prototype that will repeat itself throughout history? All of these stories, they didn't just happen in the past. They are reoccurring concepts. There will continue to be countless fathers like Nuh alayhi salam trying to discuss faith with his son. There will be new social perversions that will be challenged by the modern day examples of Lut alayhi salam. This is not something in the past, this keeps happening. There will be new political fara'ina, new political pharaohs challenged by the modern Musa alayhi salams, those who are falling in that template, in that prototype. Do you understand all of this? Do you understand this is the reason you are learning these stories? Do you understand this is the purpose of the Quran? Or, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Or is it the case that you think that you're going to enter paradise when the trials of the people that have had in the past, they're not going to have come to you yet? I'm just going to get through and walk along easy. So again, the objective of these reminders is to actually answer the question. Those who would answer the question, yes, I do think I'll get through this life and get to paradise without dealing with those trials, those are the same people that show up to the imam and say, yeah, imam, I have a question. And the question varies in its wording, but the wording is usually, you know, superfluous. It's just extra. What really matters is the idea. And the question that they have is, how can I be the most righteous while making the least effort and sacrificing the least comfort? You know, I want to be the alim, but I also want to make as much as my father. I mean, he's making good money. I mean, I got to follow in his footsteps, right? I want to be a big sheikh and a bit knowledgeable, but I mean, I don't want to actually like travel or study or learn or read or memorize or learn a language. Are you kidding me? How can I go through the footsteps of the MBA, the noble path that is so tough, but I don't want to, you know, get my feet dirty on that path. I don't want to make things difficult for myself. The answer is you can't. The answer is you can't. You have to follow in those footsteps and it's going to have to be difficult. But those who say to themselves, I've never met a strong person with an easy past. The people who are a little bit more rational, who say to themselves, I've never met a strong person who had an easy past. Those things don't come together. Strong people come from a difficult journey. Those are the ones who answer no. We know that we must be tested like the ones before us were tested. So how do we prepare ourselves for this test? What test are we awaiting? مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا. Three different types of tests. It's very interesting. Three different terms. Talking about three realms of the human being. Brothers and sisters, you have the external world around you, your circumstances, your external circumstances. You also have your physical state. How is my actual body feeling? And then you have your internal consciousness, your mental state, your emotional or spiritual state. And all three are being discussed in this ayah. This ba'sa, singular bus, means misery, misfortune. It's talking about external problems, like poverty, like displacement, like being refugees. This is your external environment and circumstance. Yes, you're going to be tested with that as well. And we see that the ummah is going through that, unfortunately, in so many countries, being displaced, suffering through poverty. So remember that your rizq is written. And remember the example of Yusuf alayhi salam, how he was in poverty and he climbed out of it and reached the highest position of domination in the land. This is why you read this Quran. This is why these examples are there, so you can remember that you can climb too. Darra yadurru means to injure, hurt, or harm. So this is referring to body problems, like sickness, injury, or chronic pains. Remember that your bodies are borrowed. They're not yours forever. It's a gift from Allah, and they're going to go back to Allah Ta'ala. You don't have it forever. You're lending this body. And remember the example of Ayyub alayhi salam, who also was at the worst of conditions, the most sickness, the most severe diseases, and subhanAllah, he climbed up and became the most healthy. And then Allah says, وَزُلْزِلُوا. And they were shaken. Zalzala, to shake, to convulse, to tremble. This is talking about your inner consciousness, such as extreme fear, questioning one's faith, having doubts. Is the promise really coming? Are we really going to win? Are we on the right path or are we on the wrong path? Is this the truth? Is this falsehood? I don't know. I'm nervous. I'm afraid. This internal consciousness is becoming shaken. It could be through peer pressure. It could be because of social disapproval. Remember to study your deen so you can respond to doubts. And remember the example of the Prophet ﷺ, who came to his wife Khadija al-Anha and said, لَقَدَ خَشِيتُ عَلَى نَفْسِي. I fear for myself. When this Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and hugged him and told him to read, اقرأ, he came down eventually and said what to his wife? I fear for myself. I don't know what's happening to me. He had this internal, he wasn't physically sick. His circumstances weren't bad, but internally he was shaken. And she reminded him, قَالَتْ لَهُ Khadija, she said, كَلَّا أَبْشِرْ, no way. Good news. فَوَاللَّهِ, I swear by Allah, لَا يُخْزِيكُ اللَّهُ أَبَدًا, لَا يُخْزِيكَ اللَّهُ أَبَدًا. Allah Ta'ala is never going to disgrace you. وَاللَّهِ إِنَّكَ لَتَصِلُ الرَّحِمُ. You bring family people, you bring families together. You're not a bad person, you bring families together. وَتَسْتُقُ الْحَدِيثِ, and you speak the truth. وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلْ, and you bear people's burdens. وَتَكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومِ, and you earn so that you can help those who have nothing. وَتَقْرِ الضَّيْفِ, and you honor the guest. وَتُعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ, and you help people in their hardest times. So subhanAllah, we should all feel the same way. That just like the Prophet ﷺ, he went through this, he felt this heavy weight of this deen, we too should feel the weight of this Islam. It's not something small, it is a weight. So the question, going back, that we have to answer is what? Do you think you'll be in paradise with these prophets that you're reading about and you won't have to walk their path? The Quran is to be read and to be memorized and to be studied and to apply and to be applied so that you can walk their path too. That is the whole point of a path. The whole point of a path is so that you end up on the same destination. How could you possibly think, I want to be at that destination, I just don't like that path? What do you think the point of a path is? SubhanAllah. So yes, it's normal to have moments of difficulty. But just remember the examples before us. Whether it's in your external world, whether it's your physical body, or whether it's in your mindset and in your spirituality, whatever difficulty you're going through, remember that the question that they asked was not, هَلْ يَأْتِ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ, is the help of Allah coming? That wasn't their question, because they knew the help of Allah was coming. They asked the question, مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ, I know it's coming, but when? This is the state of the believer. I know we're going to win in the end, but when? And then the answer, which is a very interesting answer, أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ, indeed, the help of Allah is near. You might ask yourself, how does that help? Near. It's too vague. But subhanAllah, one answer that I thought was the best answer I came across was, إِنَّمَا جَعَلَهُ قَرِيبًا لِأَنَّ الْمَوْتِ قَرِيبٌ. One commenter, he said that Allah Ta'ala said, it is near because death is always near. And so at the end of the day, the believer is not the one who is looking to this dunya for success. The believer is the one who is not attached to this dunya. Whether the success comes in this life or the next, I don't worry if we win in this world or not. I'm not worried about it because everything has to go anyhow. Ultimately, I want the victory of the Akhirah. So may Allah Ta'ala make us of those who answer the question properly. May Allah Ta'ala make us of those who understand that the tests of the past are reoccurring and are going to happen to us as well. Barakallahu feekum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.